Hello and welcome to the special focus on news from the south of the country. And now we are beginning with a special discussion with RBI Chair Professor of Economics at the Indian Institute of Management in Bengaluru, Professor Rupa Chanda, on the announcements made so far of that massive economic package announced by the Prime Minister. Professor, thank you so much for joining us. Now, you have made a special study, really, of MSMEs in the country, what their needs are, what their challenges are. What has been your overall reaction so far, and what are the constraints facing MSMEs?
So let me first comment generally about my reaction to this entire package. Just the first tranche that we are seeing of this package. So clearly, it's a welcome move because the market's been expecting this for a while. Key segments like MSMEs, NBFCs, MFIs, real estate, construction, all the important segments which have been stressed for quite some time have been targeted under this. And there's clearly a thrust on providing a lifeline, extending the lifeline, providing liquidity support, boosting confidence, which was very important because of the heightened risk aversion that was going on in the markets. A lot of schemes had been announced, but the credit was not flowing. So with all the credit guarantees and the special sort of collateral-free loans, etc., so we can expect that some of this risk aversion to go. And you know that the investment cycle will get revived to some extent. There are also some complementary moves, which is a welcome thing on the demand side to make sure that there's a bit more working capital, you know, with the EPF card, the TDS, etc. They will have a minimal impact, but at least there's a sort of dual side to what is being done, both to get employment retention, employment creation, the multiplier effects from the MSME segment, getting the shadow banking sector to start lending to these small businesses, and at the same time creating some more sort of cash in the hands of people, in the hands of the companies, so that they can also revive their businesses. I think another important thing to mention is that there's an announcement about the reforms, which will come down the line. We'll have to see. We are just seeing like a trailer of the entire movie that will play out in tranches. Yes. But you know, the Prime Minister's talked about land, labor, and legal reforms, big ticket thing. So we'll have to see. The devil will really be in the detailing. But if all that comes together, this could be really very important.
What are the constraints you see? Challenges really going ahead?
Yeah, so let me just come back to the MSME part in particular, because you know the slew of measures that are there in terms of the lending schemes, the mega fund to help them expand capacity, all these are bang on. This is exactly what was required. I don't know why it took a crisis to really get some of this going, because these problems have been there for a while. And I just want to mention a study that actually an ex-doctoral student of mine and we have done, which clearly shows that access to credit, technology, lack of technology upgradation, lack of formalization, and quality issues are the main challenges facing the MSMEs. Now, if you look at the measures that have been put out for the MSMEs, actually they address all of these. So this is very important. The definitional aspect is also very important, because now what they've done is they've relaxed the investment limit that was already done in 2006. Now they've relaxed it further. They've brought in the turnover definition, which is very important to align with the GST framework as well. And what our study shows is actually the classification scheme matters, because when you constrain firms and force them to stay small so that they can claim the benefits, they lose the benefits from economies of scale. They can't get access to large-scale imports, yes, intermediate inputs. And that has tremendous benefits, yes, in terms, yes, of productivity. So we find actually the MSME definitional change even in 2006 helped firms. Yeah. And concerns going ahead.
Thank you very much, Professor Chanda, for that insight. Thank you for the many concerns going ahead. We'll wait for the rest of the movie to play out, like you said.